Hello everyone, welcome back to lesson 5 of Python programming series. So in this lesson I'm going to talk about how to accept a user input. That means accepting a data from a user, and then also about how to convert the data that the user has entered, either in like float, integer, or an string. So for that, to accept a user input, we have to use an input function. So for example, let me write a program to accept a user to register his name. So for that, I need to create one variable. Let's say I'm creating a variable name, and then here you need to pass input. That means this input will accept an input from a user. So here let me pass a string. So if I run this program should ask a user to input his name. You see that now, what is your name? So I can enter my name here. So if I enter this, nothing happens. You don't see any output. This is because we did not include a print function. I will call what the user has entered from this variable name. So I will pass a name here. And then if I run this program, okay, Nima. And then if I run this program, you see that your name is Nima. Like this is how we create a dynamic program by accepting an input from a user. We also include to let the user enter his age. So for that, I need to put use input function, enter your age. Okay. And then I want to print his age. Okay, something like this. And now if I run this program, the program should ask a user to input his name. Okay. And then next, the program should also ask to enter his age. Okay, now you see that we get an output. Your name is Dawa and your age is 34. So now, when you are asking a user to input some text or a number, you should know that by default, Python will be taken in as a string. So for example, if I check the type of a data that is stored by the name. So if I run this program, okay, some random integer. Okay. Now you see that your name is Dawa. The type of a data that is stored by the name is a string. And similarly, let's check for each variable. So before that, I need to format this string. The type of data stored by name variable. And then let me pass a name here. And similarly, I also want to do the same thing for the age. Let me pass an age here. So now let me run this program. Okay, Dawa 45. Now you see the name, your name is Dawa, and the type of data is stored by the name variable is string. And you see here that your age is 45, and the type of data is stored by the age variable is again string. Actually, we have entered 45, that is an integer. But by default, you see that Python will be taken in as a string. Now you should know how to convert the data that has been entered by the user, either in like a integer or in float, because by default Python will be taken in as a string. So now to convert the data input by the user, you need to pass, like maybe for example, if I want to convert this age variable into an integer, then you need to pass here integer. That means when the user entered a number, it will be automatically converted into an integer data type. So if I run this now, you should see a different thing. Age 45. Now you see that Dawa is a string and 45 is now no more a string. It has converted into an integer. Now once you have converted into an integer, now it can support all the arithmetic operation like addition, division, subtraction, multiplication. Everything will be supported. And now if I want to convert this age into an float, you just need to write here float. And if I run this program, now you see that it has been automatically converted into an float. Actually, we have entered only 56. Now you see that 56.0. It has automatically embedded with 0.0. That means we are converting this input into an float. And you see that now the data type stored by the variable, each variable is a float. To a string, you just need to pass here str. But you need not have mentioned string here, because by default, Python will be taken in as a string. Any user input provided by the user will be taken in as a string. So you need not have to pass string here. So now let me give one example. So let me try to create simple calculator. So for that, let me create one variable to accept a number, something like this, enter number 1. Okay. And then Let me also create a variable y to accept a number 2. So now if I run this program, should accept two user input, that is for x and y. So enter number 2, I have entered 3, it's working perfectly. So now I want to do some simple math, that is to find the sum of these two numbers. So for that I will create a variable add, and then I want to add these two x and y, x plus y, and then I want to print, I want to pass here add addition of two number is, okay, something like this. Okay, now if I run this program, first thing is it will ask you to enter number 1, maybe I will try with 5, and then enter number 2, let's try with 10, and you see the addition of two numbers is 510. Actually this one is wrong, because actually we have to get 15. This number 1 and number 2 are taken in as a string, it will straight away do a concatenation, that means it will just join these two numbers. You see that 5 has been brought here, and the next two numbers is embedded with the what we have provided for number 2. This is because by default Python will be taken in as a string, so we can't do addition with a string, because we can only do a concatenation, that means joining two string. So we need to convert this. So for that we can convert this into integer, so we can do some math here. Once I have converted, I'm converting the user input into an integer. Now let's try again. So if I enter the same number, now you see that we get an exit output, addition of two number is 15. We can also keep on like increasing your arithmetic operations. So maybe let me also try for multiplication variable. So for that I need to pass mul here, and then if I run this program, it should work perfectly fine, because you see that we have converted the user input into an integer. Let me enter some value, 3, okay, maybe 100, something like this. And then now you see the addition of two numbers is 103, that is perfect. And then the multiplication of two numbers is 300, 3 into 100 is 300. So that's it for this video. So we'll see you in the next video lesson.